Yesterday you proved that the Bible was not the word of God. How could you now quote the Bible to predict the coming of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Please explain.
Yesterday was a debate. A format had been laid out. Originally it was 50 minutes, 60 minutes and 10. Both sides had 60-60. But the format was whoever speaks first has 10 minutes at the end. Because every advantage has a disadvantage. So both speakers speak 60 minutes each. Now, with that format, you have no time to explain each and every position. So what is the Bible? So what do we consider the Bible to be? As a whole, per se, we say this is not the book of God. And I proved it. According to all reasoning, according to the book itself, the internal evidence that Moses didn't write the books attributed to him, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John didn't write the books attributed to them, not only is it not the book of God, but it's not even the book of Matthew, Mark, Luke, or John. You're talking about 24,000 manuscripts. I challenge you, said there's no two are identical. So you've got 24,000 different gospels. Which one? You just pick that suited you, you accepted it. Who authorized you? Council of Nisi. They said, we take this, we take that, we take that. All the gospels that are now accepted were not accepted at one time. It's now pick and choose what suits you, you accept it. That's what you have done. And you say now it's the word of God. But now the word of God is in it, in the book. The word of God is in the book. The word of the prophet is in the book. The word of the historian is in the book. And pornography is in the book. Now I have to explain all that to you. I said, you see, I give you examples about the word of God. Like in the book of Deuteronomy. You see, the verse I quoted in Arabic, the same thing is in the Bible. Almost an identical idea is there. It reads, I will raise them up a prophet. I will raise them up a prophet from among the brethren like unto thee. And I will put my words in his mouth. And he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him. So who is this I? God. He's speaking to Hazrat Musa alayhi salam. That I will raise them up a prophet from among their brethren, from among the Bani Ismail. The Bani Israel are being addressed is from among your brethren, like unto thee, like you, like Musa. And he will, and I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him. So he says, this I is God. You don't have to be a theologian or a DD or an evangelist. Anybody will tell you on the plain reading of it that these are not the words of Moses, these are the words of God. Another quotation from the book of Isaiah. As if God is speaking, and God is speaking. He said, remember the former things of old. For I am God and there is none else. I am God and there is none like me. Who's that? Isaiah? No. No Jew says that Isaiah claimed divinity. They would have killed him if he did. No, he's speaking on behalf of God. God is speaking through him like a mouthpiece. This is the job of a prophet of God. He is a mouthpiece of God. He hears the words of God and he conveys them to you. So I am God and there is none else. I am God and there is no savior besides me. Who? God. God is talking. This is the word of God. You don't have to be a professor of theology to see that. There is another type of evidence in the Bible. See, now if it was a lecture, I would have done all this last night. But this is a debate. So whatever the man is throwing at you, you can't start grappling with everything. The caravan is moving and the dogs start barking. You don't start the caravan moving back to chase the dogs. You've got to move on. You've got to do your job and get on with it and finish your job. There was no occasion for explaining all these things to you. You see? Then there is the word of the prophet of God. Example, Jesus says, it has been said by them of old time, thou shalt not commit adultery. But I say unto you, that whosoever looketh upon a woman to lust after her, had committed adultery with her already in his heart. Who is this I? Jesus. Jesus is talking, the word of a prophet of God. Again, Jesus says, it has been said by them of old time, that whosoever puts away his wife, let him give her a bill of divorcement. But I say unto you, who is this I? Jesus. Words of a prophet of God. Again, Jesus says, it has been said by them of old time, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But I say unto you, who is this I? Jesus. The words of a prophet of God. Then there is another type of evidence in the Bible. First was as if God speaking. Second was as if a prophet was speaking. Third, what does the historian, how does he speak? He says in the Gospel of St. Mark, so while he, talking about Jesus, in bracket I put Jesus, while he was going forth into the way, he, Jesus, saw a fig tree in the distance with leaves. Happily, he came up to it, wanting to find figs thereon. But when he, Jesus, came, there was nothing but leaves, for the season was not yet. Who's writing? An eyewitness or a ear witness, not God and not Jesus. So see, another type of evidence. Word of God, word of the prophet, word of the historian. And there was that other type of thing I was suggesting, and I lost $100. You remember, if you were there, I lost $100. I wanted Brother Swaggart, you know, to read a certain chapter from the book, from the Bible. And he ignored it at first, maybe he had no time, and somebody from the audience prodded him again. He says, you know, look, what about that chapter Ezekiel? And there was $100 also involved, so he read it. But he read it at 60 miles an hour. So one of your university students, while I'm sitting there, he comes to me. He said, look, he read, but I didn't know. So what was the joke? I said, look, one thing is, you are at a disadvantage. You are an Arab from Arab country. You don't know English too well, number one. Number two, that the English that he was using were was archaic, old-fashioned, from the King James Version. You see, we had given him the pamphlet, which was from the New International Version, modern language, where you call a spade. But he was reading from that archaic Bible. I can't blame him for that, because he uses that. King James, he read it. And you don't know English too well. That's also a disadvantage. And he was reading at that speed I told you just now. So these are all the facts. I said, look, what you do, you go and read it, you know, in that pamphlet, and you see what he was reading. So he read it. You know, bulk of the people, I'm sure, they didn't catch the joke. No, the speed, his pronunciation, he was not as emphatic when he quotes other biblical verses. You know, he makes every word and phrase to go down your throat or down your ears. But here was something different, 60 miles an hour. So there is that type of thing, which I said, no decent man can read it to his mother, sister, daughter, or even his fiancée if she's a good woman. Now what you have to do is you have to go and read it yourself to know what was read. You didn't catch the joke. It's no fault of mine. You see, you don't understand English too well, and then, you know, the speed and the archaic language, all these things were factors where you don't catch the joke. You see. But if you catch the joke, then, you know, something that no decent man can read in his church or to his family. Right? So this is there's another type of evidence. So we have the word of God in the Bible, there is the word of the prophet in the Bible, there's the word of the historian, an eyewitness or ear witness in the Bible, and there is that other type which we say pornography in the Bible. Now we also have such a thing in Islam. We have the word of God in the Quran, only Allah's kalam. He doesn't tell you stories. We know an incident in the life of the prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that a Christian deputation had come from Najran in Medina. These were Arab Christians. They had heard that another Arab, he is claiming that he is in communication with the Almighty. He's a prophet. So he said, let's go and cross-examine him. Let us go and see what he knows. So they came to Medina, and they were housed in the Masjid al-Nabawi. They ate there, they slept there, and they had a dialogue there for 3 days and perhaps 3 nights. And when Sunday came, our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he offered the masjid to these Christians to offer their prayers. He was so broad-minded, not like us. See, some of us, we are, you know, we think our masjids are superior to the Masjid al-Nabawi that our Nabi had. No doubt, in construction, yes. He allowed them, gave them permission to make their prayers. So during the course of this discussion, the spokesman for the Christian poses the question, among so many other things. Say, all right, now tell us, O Muhammad, what is your concept of God? And our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he doesn't fumble. You know, well, you see, it's like this and like that. No, he doesn't do that. He is the God of Abraham, Moses, and David, and Solomon, you know, who spoke to Abraham. No, he doesn't talk like that. See, when the question is posed, what is your concept of God? So the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as if he was pressing his spiritual buttons, trying to contact fi lawhim mahfuz, the head computer. So, oh my Lord, what shall I say? Nobody heard that. There were no buttons to press. I said, as if, I hope you people understand that. Then when I go away, don't create a controversy. He said, Muhammad pressed buttons. You know, he had a computer. I said, as if. Oh my Lord, what shall I say? Comes the answer through him. Qul, say, huwa Allahu ahad. He is Allah, the one and only. Allahu samad, God the eternal absolute. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He does not beget and is not begotten. Wa lam yakun lahu kufuwan ahad. And there's nothing like unto him. Full stop. And you see, this is our concept of God. Now you see, it's on a different level. He is made to say, Qul, say. He's asking, oh my Lord, what shall I say? Nobody heard him say that. But comes the answer, say. It doesn't fit into normal speech. They are asking, what is your concept of God? So you don't tell him, say. Somebody asks you, what is 12 times 12? What do you say? 144. Am I right? 6 times 6? 36. You don't say, say 36. Say 144. Do you say like that? No. Why say? Because the words are being put through his mouth. From fi lawhim mahfuz, from the preserved tablet, from the head computer. See, he's in contact, he's got that machine. Spiritual buttons. Ya Bari Ta'ala is communicating. What shall I say? He says, say, hu Allahu ahad. Now, that I say. Look, all these things that I told you is not in the Quran. In the Quran, you open Surah Ikhlas, chapter 112. You start. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of God, most gracious, most merciful. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Say is Allah the one and only. Allahu samad. God the eternal absolute. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He does not beget and is not begotten. Wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. And there's nothing like unto him. Full stop. That's all. Where he was. What was the occasion? How did it come about? Nothing. So only the word of God. Everything else were the details given to us later on. They said, look, this is what happened. People who were eyewitnesses, your witnesses, what's happening, what our Nabi said, what happened, all that put together is our knowledge. You find the other details in the books of Hadith, words of the Prophet, separate volume. Allah's Kalam, separate volume. Hadith, words of the Prophet, separate volume. History, Imam Ghazali, Ibn Rushd, Ibn Taymiyyah, great writers, separate books. And our Arabian Nights, also separate book. Yes? You know the Arabian Nights, you know, fairy tales, those filthy, dirty stories were circulating around the campfire. You know, the Arabs also had something to pass time with. You know, pre-Islam, before Islam, and even maybe after Islam. You know, under Harun al-Rashid, Mamun al-Rashid, we don't know how the empire developed, and they were wanting to pass time, you know, somehow, lightheartedness, jokes, filthy, dirty stories, you stole around the campfire, right? They're written now in books. Fitzgerald, he translated it, The Arabian Nights, the unexpurgated edition. I read it, and I enjoyed it very much. I was a young boy, ooh, I loved it, you know. The unexpurgated editions, but it's separate. It's not in the Quran. It's not in the works of the sayings of the Prophet. It's not in the works of a historian. Separate book. So we have the words of God, word of the Prophet, word of the historian, and pornography all in separate compartments. They have it all in one volume.